My name is Elliott Barnhart. I'm a hydrologist with the Wyoming-Montana Water Science Center. I mostly am trained in microbiology, and I also collaborate a lot with Montana State University in Bozeman. What is innovative about our idea is a new way to develop coal in a cleaner way, to convert it to natural gas underground with microorganisms. But not just there, we're also looking at greener ways to utilize this technology, such as implementing algal biofuels and cyanobacteria in the whole process to create a sort of a closed loop energy system. So this would help problems such as coal development. It would create natural gas from coal in a much cleaner way. Right now, mercury levels are rising in fish. We need to find better ways to develop the coal underground, and microorganisms have the capability to convert the coal to natural gas and harvest that gas on the surface. This technology can be implemented in a much cleaner way by reusing the water resources to grow algae or cyanobacteria, algal biofuels. We can also use some of the algal byproducts to stimulate coal bed methane production. We've got a field site in eastern Montana where we sample water and we get to camp out and enjoy the outdoors in eastern Montana when we're doing this research. So we'd like to implement some of this technology at a small scale in the field site and expand out depending on how it goes. Our project was facing, you know, as any project, funding issues, but once we got the process ironed out, we could show that coal bed or methane production could be enhanced, and also incorporating algal biofuels into the project, we were able to get more funding and more graduate students working with us and for us to pursue this issue. If this project succeeds, there's coal reserves all over the nation, all over the world, that pretty soon with regulations and with coal plants shutting down, this project could help utilize those coal resources in a much cleaner way. Actually, I grew up in southeastern Montana in the coal fields, and I was interested in how microbes convert coal to natural gas. And we're still researching it. There's still many questions yet to be answered about that process. But I think that's really interesting. And I'd also like to see this technology applied to my hometown in eastern Montana that could benefit from a cleaner coal development. That's kind of my passion. I've really enjoyed going back home and doing research.